This is really, this is food porn, right?
Yeah,
up your alley.
Food porn, yeah, boy, I love it.
This is great.
I'm so hungry I could fuck a horse.
In honor of DJ Laz, okay. I am making a pan con mixtape. But estilito mío, we're doing a brisket vaca frita, a little Gruyere cheese, lettuce, tomato, pickle, cotija cheese, a little cilantro aioli, and papita juliana, and we're gonna grill, dog.
I can't pronounce the second one.
I said. No, no, all I heard was juliana's coming.
Cotija cheese.
No, what? What's the name with a cheese?
Cotija.
Cotija.
Yeah, it's like a Mexican parmesan, dog.
Did he say cochina cheese?
Cochina cheese, oh, exactly.
We've seen some of those. I'm not a foofy guy, clearly. I like, you know, I like my food, and pan con mixtape is one of my favorites. And I will tell you, Frankie has come to multiple of my radio shows and brought some food off the hook, so I can't wait for a pan con mixtape.
Normally, you haven't had mine cooked yet. It, though, and then Frankie just brought it.
Is he taking credit? Yeah, there it is, got it.
Dane, by the way.
Dane. Have you met Dane,
right?
Dane! What's up, Papa? The real chef?
Yes.
Yeah, the real one. Absolutely. You already know.
I love
it. Makers in the building, y'all. So, Frankie, what's up, man? Talk to us about this Michael B. Tech.
I'm gonna plate it for y'all. I toasted the bread. Actually, I didn't toast it. Dane did all the work. Because I can't be doing extra work with all this.
Right, food. No. You don't wanna get the gold dirty.
For sure.
Yeah, I have no limo.
Dirty.
No.
We're gonna get
I'm surprised his neck ain't green by now.
That
thing's
got heavy.
I know, it looks heavy. But he's got he's been bobbing his head for a long time, so he's got a strong neck.
Never.
I'm sorry. Never. He's my best friend for 20 years. Yeah, I've been saying shit like that for a long time.
I love it. I tell him.
Oh, so this is the brisket vaca frita. It has a little bit of Gruyere cheese.
Gruyere
DJ Laz, dog. You know what I'm saying? We can't just put no American regular old process.
I thought it was gonna be Hialeah cheese. I would have been straight with that too.
I mean, they got it in Hialeah too. It's just expensive at Sedano's.
For sure.
Shout out Sedano's.
So wait, I got a question for y'all.
What's up?
Because listen, I'm telling you, I'm a good eater. I'm not a good cooker. Let's just be real.
Cooker.
How did you guys learn how to cook?
Well,
YouTube.
One of us.
Fue por necesidad.
YouTube.
No, he's like one of us knows how to cook.
This is one of us.
One of us knows how to cook and. Bro, I learned in different restaurants growing up. I didn't get a lot of education, dog. I was the bingo running around in the street.
This is education right here, buddy.
So I had to go to work, and 20 years of working, aquí estamos contigo. Something happened, dog. I don't know what it is. I must have did something right.
Shows a pan con mixtape for it. Incredible.
I'm not mad at this. So we got vaca frita with some can't pronounce cheese.
Gruyere cheese is very melty cheese. And
can we just change it into gangster cheese? Can we make it gangster cheese?
Let's do it. Some gangster. Laz is here. Some 305 gangster cheese.
Gangster cheese. Like gangster.
Some 305 gangster cheese.
Yeah, I like that. Look at
we got some lettuce. This is some Hialeah lettuce.
I like Hialeah lettuce.
Here.
Not what are those things?
These are papita juliana. So you fry
those
off.
The regular papitas.
No,
the juliana. The Cuban style. Papitas, we have a little machine that makes them into a little shape, and then we drop them in the fryer, a little salt and pepper. Those ain't coming from no can.
They're not in a bag.
Really good though.
Yeah, they are. No, and at 4 o'clock in the morning, borracho beer.
Yeah, I don't even put them on the pan con mixtape. I just stick my hand in there.
Wow.
Love
it. Love it. What are these? These are some gangster tomatoes.
Are those homestead tomatoes?
These are homestead tomatoes.
Everything better be authentic.
Oh yeah, we gave the 305, right? Got homestead. Homestead a new name. It's not just the 305. It's the five.
Just the five.
It's the five side of the 305.
Because it's all the way down.
Casa Malanga.
It's all the way in Casa de Malanga, exactly. I don't know if Sofala likes pickles. He likes pickle, but he likes them whole.
Bro, I love the shots that these guys take at each other during this is the best cooking show on the planet.
I had a piece of ice in my mouth. I couldn't even respond to that.
Normally, cooking shows are about cooking and boring. Yo, this is the shit.
Yo, you know,
this
you know
is
how
the best
that
cooking show I've seen. So is this the part where I go, okay, that was a fuck up. Here's an edit. And we're back to the show because we had some technical difficulties.
Yeah,
probably interference with my leg. But let's move on.
What were we talking about? Sofala loving whole pickles. Okay.
Right. Yes.
All right, we're going with.
You got no comeback for that. All right, keep going. I got you, brother.
Some papita juliana. Okay, right on the top there to make it nice and crunchy.
Not for nothing, the shit looks delicious.
Beat that.
No, it's not. My pan con pite at home does not look like this. Just
no,
saying.
No, your pan con pite at home is peanut butter and jelly, right?
Yeah, 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 so, no, pan con peanut butter.
That's how we said with Magic the other day. It's a wish sandwich. I wish it was a pan con pite.
Damn right.
The wish sandwich. Yeah. How many of those have we eaten in our
oh,
lives?
Oh, God.
Now, before all the... For the fame and before el bolde, what was that one meal when you weren't the DJ Laz, bro, and you were just Lazaro Mendez?
By the way, it's the same meal today.
Nice.
Which that's a, nothing to say. Arroz con huevo frito, really.
Oh, comida de puta.
Oh, dang. Oh, my God.
It's not that other special sauce you're thinking about. Is that sopla standing too close?
It's a special sauce.
It's not the special sauce. It's a different sauce.
Wait, man, technique is it?
No, you know what it is, and he makes it look pretty, too.
Yeah, of course.
My shit does not look that pretty when I get home.
Hey, listen, I've looked like this for a long time. I've had to look pretty for, you know, for my whole life.
So you just make your food look pretty since you're suffering on the top part.
The girls gotta love me for something. No, I got my wife for a reason. It wasn't because I was cute.
No, for sure. And it's definitely not the size of your cock either. So it's
definitely not.
No.
I'm more of a grower. I'm more of a grower than a shower.
Frankie's a grower, not a shower. What the fuck is this? Oh my God.
I told you this was the best cooking show on the planet.
Oh my God, look at that. He's putting perico on our sandwich.
What is this, bro?
This is the cotija cheese I was talking about. Yeah,
cochina cheese.
The cochina cheese. Stuff. Yeah,
I do. The cochina cheese on top.
I put cochina cheese on everything, bro. I don't know what it is. It just like brings everything.
Where do you buy cochina cheese? Just out of curiosity.
You can buy it anywhere.
Fresco y ma.
Yeah, you can. Sedanos.
La Cayocho.
La Cayocho.
Boom.
And then now the only thing que falta. If you look, you can hear it.
I remember being a kid and listening to you on the radio, and you've always been that staple, that voice of Miami.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'll take that as a huge compliment.
How did you even get into radio?
Dude, my brother was a DJ. Rest in peace to my brother Ray. He would go and DJ parties instead of quinceañeras and house parties. And I was a JIT.
Right.
And I had 17 surgeries on my leg, so a lot of my schooling and everything was at the crib.
Okay.
So I remember when I was able to, in between surgeries, learn how to walk again, all messed up, but learn how to walk again.
Yeah,
I would go with, 100%. I would go with my brother to different parties. And I remember the one party that went, ding, this is what I want to do. My brother went, made people happy by playing music, met girls, and at the end of the night, somebody gave him money. I go, on yo, I found my career. This is what I want to do. Hey. And then I just, you know, once I started doing parties with him and stuff like that, I wanted to take it to the next level. I said, damn, I don't just want to be the DJ at the private party. I want to be the guy on the radio.
Right.
And it's like anything, man. You put your mind to it. You work hard.
That's right.
And, you know, luck never hurts anybody.
Right.
But at the end of the day, it's like Pitt says, the harder you work, the luckier you get.
Hell yeah.
That's true.
So,
yeah, absolutely.
You know, and you also put the grind in.
We've known you for a long time. You've always been a real ass dude. No matter what, you've always been a real ass dude, so that's gotta have taken you far as well.
Listen,
it's not just the business aspect, but it's the personable aspect as well, right?
Michael, the Laz that you hear on the radio is the same Laz you're gonna run into at Home Depot, is the same Laz you're gonna see at West Marine, is the same Laz you're gonna see in the Keys.
You might not,
I don't change.
You might not remember this.
Oh, shit.
You might not remember this.
I don't know what happened.
Here we go.
This was a long time ago. This gotta be more than 20 years ago.
No.
I worked at a Chevy dealer.
Right.
And I'm not sure if you bought the Corvette or somebody you were with bought the Corvette. I'm not sure, okay. But it was a car from there. It was an expensive car and you were there. And I freaked out because he was DJ Laz and I was the guy that used to have to wash the cars before they got turned into their new owners. Real shit, I'm not lying. I totally washed the car. I was there when they turned it into you and your group of people and you gave me a tip.
Big thing.
Nobody ever gives a tip to somebody when they're giving you their new car.
Was it like $4 or was it like a $20
bill? No, it was like $10 or something. And, hey, back then that was a dime bag. You know what I'm saying?
You're welcome. I got you high.
Thank you, Laz, for making him a degenerate.
You're welcome.
No, I was a degenerate way before that.
Way before Laz gave him a $10 dime bag.
But my point of the story is that Laz is so real about it, and he was just such a cool guy. He knew that I was washing the car. He saw me. He saw I looked good, and the dude, you know, me tocó con algo.
Little people, it's like anything in life. When somebody, doesn't matter what you're doing, if you see somebody working hard at something and taking pride in something, whether it's here or up here.
Yeah.
You gotta reward that.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know what? And look how many years later you remembered that.
Of course. Yeah, of course. And I'm still smoking like a champ.
God bless you. Congratulations.
Smoking, bro.
Congrats.
We could not give DJ Laz a traditional palomilla pango pite. So
no,
what
sir.
We did today
right.
is we braised a brisket with mojo, naranja agria, beer, onions, olives, the whole tank. Yeah, right?
I thought I was gonna go home and make this. That shit.
No, you're not doing that. And then we put it on the plancha, okay. make it into a brisket baga frita
yes,
with man. Some Gruyere cheese.
Mm. No, we changed the name. It's gangster cheese now.
Gangster cheese. Mm-hmm. We got lettuce, tomato, pickles, cilantro aioli, and papita, juliana. And then we got the...
Devil's dandruff.
No, not the devil's dandruff. This is the cochina cheese.
Cochina cheese.
I'm sorry.
There it is.
On some nice toasted Cuban bread. So all I can say now is buen provecho. Welcome to Hialeah.
Ooh, oh, that's pretty.
Mira esto, bro.
It's actually too pretty.
No, it's never too pretty. Look, look. Every time the prettier it is,
I don't know if the camera can. Cameraman, can you angle in here real quick?
Yeah.
This is. It is pretty porn.
You know what? I can't. Usually I don't eat on the show, but I'm with DJ Laz, wow. dog. I'm with DJ
so
Laz.
So tender.
I gotta do my
thing. Really good, Frank.
Oh my god.
This is normally the reaction I give when I eat at 4 o'clock in the morning drunk, because everything tastes good. That shit's amazing.
All I gotta say is yeah. Dave. Dave,
not,
you did a great job,
you're
real
not
boy.
Saying much, because you're half drunk now, so.
I'm not half drunk. Yo.
He's a veteran.
That shit's badass. Yo.
Wow. Oh, yeah, that's.
Well.
After you finish chewing, so I'm gonna, ask a, question that you can answer when you're done chewing. Mm-hmm. So.
Okay.
What comes next? What's next for DJ Laz? Where do we see DJ Laz next year, the year after?
Well, it's pretty simple. For me, it's keep grinding, keep working hard, and taking advantages of opportunities that are presented
right.
and making the best of it.
Yeah.
Right. Because the day that you think you're up top, it's a wrap. There's always somebody out there that's hungrier,
mm-hmm.
that's better,
absolutely.
That's this. And you know what? I've been blessed, thank God, to have longevity in this business, in a business that a lot of people don't get to stay in the same market.
That's right.
For years.
And you've been able to transcend markets and be able to do stuff wherever you wanted.
Babo, today, you know the best compliment to me is two of them. Number one, when people meet me and never see me and they say to me, Laz, man, I love you. I feel like I've known you my whole life.
Oh, listening to you every day.
You know what I'm saying? You know? To me, that's like, wow. Or when I get, I can't believe that I'm here with DJ Laz now and my kids listen to DJ Laz because I used to listen to DJ Laz.
True.
To me, that is the biggest compliment on the planet.
That's awesome.
You know what I'm saying?
That's so generational swag you
yeah,
got going on,
cut. Gracias, yo.
I'm glad.
Man, let me hit the wooden leg. There you go.
No, but I'll cook it for you.
Dale, pagada.
That's the most
humbling.
Humble answer and the most humble feeling you can have in the world. Well, bro, there's nothing like that,
well,
bro.
Well, think about it. Look, ready? Thank you very much, by the way.
You're welcome.
But it's like your food. You make amazing food, but if the people don't support your food.
Yeah, I have no business.
What happens?
Yeah, I can't cook no
you
more.
You got nothing. You're gonna be, you and your people at the house are gonna be like, oh, Chef Frankie, tremendo chef. Yo,
que
rico da la comida.
Yeah.
All four people leave and it's done.
Yep.
The people make you who you are.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? So thank you to everybody who's watching this, who has listened to me on the radio for years. Thank you very much. I'm humbled. I appreciate you guys. And to me, I can't wait for what's next. The only person who knows what's next?
Yep. Man upstairs.
Baby Jesus. That's it. But I will tell you what's good. Whatever is next, this will be part of it. I'll tell you that shit right now. And that's real talk.
Any advice you want to give to anybody watching this who's like,
yeah,
yeah, man, you know, anybody trying to be an artist, up and coming,
sure.
Bye, okay, I think it all pertains up and coming chef, up and coming restaurant owner, up and coming anybody, up and coming, bro.
Work hard.
Yo.
Don't worry about no's. Those are great. That should be motivation for you to do the next thing.
Mm-hmm.
Have thick skin, because in this business, whether it's a music business or whether it's the cooking business, you're gonna have people that talk negatively about you.
Yeah.
Take that as motivation and go with it.
Right.
Don't worry about what anybody said. Tunnel vision and you do you. Those same people that are talking shit will be the first people at the grand opening of your restaurant
right,
in Kendall. Being, oh my God, Frank, I'm so glad you came to Kendall.
And that's when you get a punk on me there that fell on the floor.
But it's still good, you
it
know what I'm saying?
So good.
And I am gonna make another, like, It's not even a comment, it's a promise. I told you we're gonna do a show on the boat. We're gonna, you know, catch lobster.
I'm looking forward to
that. Yeah, we're gonna do that. I'm also gonna buy you guys fans for the studio, because I am sweating like a hooker in church. Okay? Just so you know.
That's the devil's bad joke.
I got you.
No, I
got you. These lights, bro. No.
Okay, I think we're making him nervous.
Bro, no, it's not nervous. You got porn lights in here. Yo, for real. It's like, hey, look at me la comida.
Speaking of porn, right nut?
Left nut?
Dick in the middle.
Yeah. Okay, we both got some left for people. But you know what? I'm the big dick in the middle. Yeah. Boom! Drop mic, come on, this bitch.
Are we going on the boat? Where you guys
Let's go.
Going?
We're going on the boat.
We're leaving?
We're going on the boat,
well, hold on. No,
we got fish to catch.
I'm not.
Why? Wrap up the sandwich. Wrap up the
I'm trying. Hold on. Wait for. I want to go on the boat. Jen, don't let them leave, Jen.